Okay. Let me load up the replay to see if it's the correct one.
Okay.
It should be the 2111, but it's with like a Vladimir. So if I see a Vlad or a Janna, we're good. Yeah, this is the one. Okay. My God, their team comp is. Well, their team comp is good late game if Swain gets if Yi and Swain and okay, actually each of them can get rolling. This is a good team comp for like solo queue. Your team comp is terrible. You guys have nothing. Like the only way we win you win this is if you're ahead early, like to be honest. And obviously you win. It's just that like I don't know how, but like you guys win, so it's kind of interesting.
Well, this is a really weird game.
Swear to God,
So,
it's the it's fucking fiesta, isn't it? It's like a fucking
yeah.
oh my fucking God, dude.
You know, a real low elo game.
This is a clown fiesta. This is what I like to see. Like I like seeing clown fiestas, but like at the same time, I kind of don't. My fucking God, man. Like, what the hell? Here we go. Here we go. Okay, so, this is you winning a game before we see how the coaching takes place. So we're gonna take a look at runes. Your item build is absolutely perfect. You can't get anything different. Actually, okay, if you're afraid of them, actually no, you're fine. Your item build is perfect. This thing needs to go away. Yeah, it generates you more gold, but 5% health and mana per kill is better. Like I said before, it's the only difference you gotta get. And
Yes.
that's pretty much it. So I'm gonna move this here, I'm gonna move this, minimize this down here, and I'm gonna wait for the game to start. Hit him! Oh my God, no! You gotta same rule. It might be a 2v1 at this time. You hit him and you can't stand near this wall. Because you're gonna lose all trades if you stand near the wall. Oops. But you can also not do anything. If you're not gonna do anything, like sit back like this, don't get into range of his autos. Why is it changing so constantly? Okay. Wow, she leveled traps level 1? You should win all trades if Janna gets back. Once Janna gets back, you should be able to just punch him. Okay, that's okay. That isn't really a good sign if you took that much damage. To be honest, I think that you can hit him a lot more. And if you force yourself to burn a pot, you've already lost every single trade forward. Because burning a pot is like burning 50 gold, because that's how much it costs. So now you need about 3 to 4 minions to make up that cost of a potion. In doing so, you are now farther behind. So technically, in terms of minions, since she hasn't burned her pot, you're behind because if you subtract 4 minions from yourself, you're currently at 6, and she's at 7, so she's ahead. In terms of gold, because you have less to spend on your item because you're gonna need to make up for that potion you just bought. You know, and then you miss
Yeah.
the cannon, which is even worse. But it's fine. Now that Bard's out of mana, you should not be afraid. Like you jump. You can jump, but like the thing is, if you jump, you don't have a potion, so you would lose out. Personally, I'd jump to fuck this Bard up because he's out of mana. You could take advantage of the fact that they have no resources at their disposal. Okay, is that it? Is that the best? Keep going, and then you have your heal too. See, look at that. The other thing you can do is remember that your jump does a shit ton of damage, so you got 4 autos off in there, and that was really good. So then you could jump on her again. You would cancel an auto, but that doesn't matter because your auto was on cooldown anyway because you're slow attack speed. I think that with a little bit more pressure, you could have gotten a kill right there, and then you would have been able to purchase your pickaxe. And then you come back to lane with a pickaxe, and then you do it again on the Bard, and then he starts backing up and stops harassing you for no reason because he realizes, like, wow, this Trist hurts! Like, fuck, you didn't realize that before, man. You gotta show them that you hurt them, but like you can't do it recklessly. So here, and there was no opportunity for you to be reck fucking bitch stole your CS. There was no opportunity for you to show recklessness in the lane. Like every time I told you to harass, it was because it was a punish rather than a, oh my God, it's free. No, Because if it's a, oh my god, it's free kind of harass, like, you just walk up and hit them, sometimes that's not the best idea. Here, I see a lot of opportunity for you to just hit them because he's out of position, and when they're out of position, their AD carry cannot, like, respond accordingly, unless, which is why I said for you to do it before, unless they're you're stunned. And in this case, you were not stunned. Yes! 1, 2, 3. What the fuck? Who does that? That was so yours? Oh my god. I'm so sad. Oh, it's Swain mode. Alright, first of all, I'm a Swain player. I love playing Swain. You don't fucking take teleport on Swain in solo queue. Boom!
He's bad, so.
Like, if he misses his fucking key, like, I don't know how bad you could be as Swain. Oh my god. Alright, well. Yeah. You know, Maria, it was nice knowing. What?! It's a waste of the shield, to be honest. My god. Y'all are greedy as fuck. Alright, so here's what I would have done. You want to take things that are always free. It's the rule is that you do a bunch of low level investments, like low scale investments, instead of taking a bunch of high risk, high rewards, because high risk always presents high rewards, and it's always tempting. Greed is in fact good, yes. However, it's not always correct. So in this case, so when you did this jump here, after you killed the Jinx, actually, let me just watch the positioning. Wait. So when you came up here, it should be like this. You were in a favorable advantage. So you go this way, and then you kill this guy, free. You remember that she flashed. You flashed too, so now you should be that your flash is timed with her flash. Okay, jump down, like this way. It's done. There isn't any other possible way you guys get another kill from here, because think about it like this. You've already flashed, and you have no other spells at your disposal. Your E is down, your jump is up, but that all you have is your jump, your Q is down, you have no heal. The only way you fight someone here is if another person is already under 50%. No situation calls for that, and the only thing you would do is you would get them to maybe 75%, 60% HP with your full auto attack combo. Nothing else. So I just recommend you jumping down. Like, just flee! Jump down. And also, you remember that Fog of War thing? Because they're all missing, don't make your move until you see them. So, Malzahar might be there, but what can he do to you? Like be real about it, because he's not 6, he can't do anything to you. Like, if you're scared of him autoing you to death, like, damn, like, look at Yi, he's gonna auto you to death. Like, Malzahar ain't gonna do shit. You know? So, to be honest, you could have jumped out of there and just kept walking, and you would have been safe. You might be ridiculously low on HP, but you probably would have escaped. Like this Janna. Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. Janna has a shield, and she's really mobile, but still, yeah. Wait, so you could have gotten pickaxe. This lane isn't very heavy on the again, it's like the whole potion thing. You have 200 gold. You should have bought a potion and no, 2 potions and a ward, because that would have resulted in a lot more sustain than that of a vamp scepter. Because when you're purchasing a vamp scepter, you're basically denying yourself an item advantage power spike. Now, looking at your opponent, they have a boot. Like, that doesn't matter. Like, who the fuck cares if they have a boot? But like, because that means you come out on top, but you want to come out as you again, you want to spend your gold as efficiently as possible. So Janna comes in, she has Frostfang, which means that your damage is going to go up like crazy. Okay, that's fine. Oh, Jesus, not again. Because you have a 1.5% lifesteal, and if you have a pickaxe, that's plus 25 damage. Keep going. Jump. Ward the bush. Yes! Jump! Yes! Okay, good. That's how it's done. Dodge! No! Okay. Right there, I would have when I see the W, sometimes what I really hate most about playing against Jinx is that the W comes out, but then half the animation disappears, but it still goes out. And like, sometimes I'll dodge and I'll hate myself for like not dodging because I saw it disappear. I'm like, oh, it must have gone out. No! You gotta practice the dodge. Like, that one was a simple dodge. You cannot, you don't do a hard left. Like, your character should not be turning left, or in your case, up. You have to hug the wall. Like, for that part, you had to hug the wall in particular. It's one particle, but, like, you gotta get used to it, because, like, that's how you feel the AD carry. Oh, yeah. Oh, a little late. Yeah. You saw kill opportunity there. I don't know how, but, like, because, like, last game, you didn't see a lot of kill opportunity. Right there, you probably saw it, because the reasoning behind your jump right there was because, Bard isn't there, and you have blue, you have red, you're also about to hit six, and you can punish them.
Yeah.
Yeah. Do not jump in near tower, obviously, unless you can quickly get the kill and, like, take one tower shot at max.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I never jump on this.
Yeah. But yeah, you actually saw kill opportunity there. Like, I'm basically justifying what your jump was, and it's late, but, like, it's fine. Now, the thing is, you should do it when they try to CS. Good dodge. Yes. Hit her! You have red buff. What are you afraid of? Being out-traded? She has a blade. She has a boot. That doesn't give her damage. You have a vamp scepter. While that is not an effective item, you also have a vamp scepter that can give you lifesteal. You win all trades. You have a shield. You can't lose. If he hits you twice, you don't give a fuck. You hit her three times. Throw an E on her. She loses all trades. It's good. You're good. But remember that your bread buff's about to run out, so use it as effectively as possible. In fact, jump! Fuck this bitch up! Oh my gosh. Yeah. Okay, so stable laning phase, nothing too out of the ordinary. Remember that your flash is up when her flash is up, so like when you jump in, you can take advantage of that. Yeah. It's like roughly the same timer. I don't know if you can still hear me, but yeah, that's roughly the same timer.
Yeah, I can hear you.
Ward the bush, don't face check it. Ward the bush. Always have that bush warded. Like, you also can't allow him to just walk in there. Just, yeah, look, Jinx is out of mana. And, fucking really, man. Nice. That's fine, her heal's down. Okay, kill the creeps, and then run. Okay, when you see him, jump. Don't jump too early. Jump. Oh, okay, well, it's too late. Well, it's okay, you don't have to jump anyway, because he didn't decide to all-in you for no reason, and he has no ult. But, like, what I would do is, basically, if you time the jump just right before the silence hits, or if he ults you, you can jump while he's ulting you. And that, as funny and stupid as it sounds, when you jump while he's ulting, he's gonna be like, what the fuck, how are you moving, kind of thing. And you get into a safe area, and, like, you're in the air while he suppresses you. It's so fucking, like, hilarious. But timing has to be perfect. Yes! This is free! Jump forward! Pressure the Bard. And that's your Jax, not an enemy Jax. Wait, Malzahar was top? Wow, dude, this is fucking awful. They just lost first tower off of that. What a joke. That's so sad. Like, you just gave up first tower, first Drake?
Yeah, hold up.
This Drake call is kind of rough, but the reason why is because this guy's up. You don't want to call for Drake unless you know where Master Yi is, because he can just come in and steal it. He's really fast. You can't slow him unless you have ulti. Actually, be careful here.
I didn't
here.
Have my combo up. Here. Yeah.
No, keep going. Hit him. Oh my god. So right here, I would have done. Hang on. I'm gonna switch over to their point of view. This is their point of view. Oh my god, you would've won. Okay, so here's, I know how you would've won that. You know how I told you about the whole in and out bush thing last game? It's pretty hard to do it now, but basically, so right here, like when you're running, okay, you flash, you go this way, do not turn here, turn here. Oh, never mind. You would've lost it anyway. And the reason why is because he has red smite, right, and he just smited you. You've seen, you would've lost it regardless. If you know Kale's coming, and you have jump, I would've jumped here as soon as possible, and then try to get into range of Janna's heal, but that's pretty much all you can do because she can try to shield you after. Basically, if he did not red smite you there, I would have recommended you just walk into the bush because you would have he would have dropped vision, so he stops for like a quarter of a second, which allows you to make your next move. You have fast reaction times. So you can A, jump backwards to your teammates to let them finish her off, or B, just hit her. But if by hitting him, you know, you give yourself away. So that's just a heads up. My god, Swain. Use your Q. Use your fucking Q properly. Holy shit, he doesn't know how to Swain. Well, I mean, but like, that's because he's retarded. Jesus Christ. Okay, you got a BF sword and a boot. Did you have money for a potion? Yes, you did. Wait a minute, what? Wait, is this a bug? You have 1200 gold. You should have bought a pickaxe. And then a vision ward. Yeah. What?
I don't know.
Oh my gosh. Well, let's see, with this pickaxe right here, maybe you could have killed him sooner. Oh my god, they're so juicy for you right now. You could kill that Yi if you had a pickaxe. You could kill any of them if you had a pickaxe for that extra 25 damage. But also, wait, where'd you use your ulti on Malzahar? Okay, so here's what I would have done. Right here? When you catch this Malz, I'll show you what I mean. So, you break his spell immune. Okay, so you break it one, two, and he already hit by it once. Hop. Yeah, hop on him first, then shoot the fourth auto. And then you have a re-jump. He flashes, okay, that's fine. You bear the risk of doing this again, but you jump in again. And here's what, I would have jumped in again. I would have done my best to finish him off. And if I can't finish him off, look at the next available target. He just meditated, you don't know that, but you just gotta hit him anyway. As soon as he dies, which is basically one auto, you have more than enough damage from his one auto. 143, 169. With pickaxe guaranteed, you shoot him. He dies. You A, jump backwards, or B, reposition down here so that you can kill Bard. In this case, you do neither. It's alright, though. So right there, you would have had like 5 kills already, because you could have killed a bot lane like 2 times, and then you killed them in the jungle, and then you could have killed them here. If Janna doesn't dodge that, I would be so mad. Like, I don't know how you cannot dodge that when it's so slow as a particle. Janna, use your Q. Use your Q. Use your Q. 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 God,
This is kind of where I realized that I have to carry.
What the fuck is this? They're all out of mana. They're all like, oh my god. I would be typing so much right now. Oh my god. So now you have the pickaxe. You guaranteed you actually have enough damage to do it. Nice. Hit. Two. Three. One more. Jump! Yes! Boom! Keep going. They've got nothing. You're only afraid of auto attacks. You have to go on Jinx though. Unless you're fast enough to kill Malz, but yeah. You're only afraid of auto attacks right there. Push, 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 get that tower. Why would you shield yourself? What the fuck?
He didn't want the tower shot, I think.
It didn't even. Oh, okay, well, I don't even. What? Oh, fucking retard. God. Okay, back out. Oh, I like that. Throw an E on her. Hit her! She has no mana! Actually? Yeah, fight! She has no mana. Also, you need Executioner's Calling. Ooh. And the only reason why is because it's Swain. And you get my reasoning for that, right?
No.
Executioner's Calling cuts Swain's healing in half. So that way he doesn't sustain as much. He also doesn't look like the kind of player that'll build Spirit Visage against a Kale and a Vladimir. So by building Executioner's Calling, you cut his healing up.
Okay.
Executioner's Calling does not mean you have to build Mortal Reminder, by the way. So instead, just take the Executioner's Calling. It's one item. It's a small investment, but a small investment to cut the healing in half. Not just cutting Swain's healing in half, but also cutting Jinx's heal and lifesteal in half, and Master Yi's healing in half. You come out super far ahead. Yes. You can kill her. Like, she is easily killable. Just E her, and then jump on her, and then get autos. Like, oh my god, that is so free. Like, I'm so hungry for that kill right there. Yes! What? Okay. Well, now it's no longer free. You're just killing the minions. Like, yeah, you got four autos off, but on minions. Alright. Kill that minion, then bounce. You might want to bounce. You really want to bounce. Oh my god. Alright, well, jump when you see his Q. Yes. It's kind of bullshit, but yeah. Alright, well, you didn't do what I... You did what I said, but, like, you gotta jump sooner, like, when you see him stop. Is what I meant.
Yeah, okay.
Why? Why, Jax? Why? Ooh, good knockup to stop the Jinx that can't even get close enough. Wow, so great. What the f... God, you suck. Kale! No! Yes! No! Yeah! You're retarded. You're gonna give this Swain so many kills. Like, oh my god. So, at this point, you see how fed he's getting, right? Now you need an Executioner's Calling, because, like, he's gonna be level 11. And you know what it means when he's level... Oh my god, I can't believe he landed that. When he's level 11, he's dead. She should be able to... Oh, never mind. The dot tick didn't kill her. When he's level 11, that means he has level 2 ulti. You being level 9 means that, you know, you're not gonna be able to, kill him that quickly. You know, he has level 2 ulti now. Like, his birds give him a shit ton of HP back. Yo, be careful on that jump, though. You did just jump over the wall. I saw the particle. If they saw that and he used a Q and E on you, like, if he were a good Swain, like, you're lucky he has no mana, but, like, you see how much damage the snare... Why does he... Okay. You see how much damage the snare did, right? Like, just treat that... Just be careful of that. Like, you don't have jump. Because you don't have jump, so... They could kill you if he had mana. Like, all or nothing, he could have killed you because he had, and if he had no mana. Like, right there. If he didn't if he had mana, he could have killed you. Blah. I said, if he had no mana, he could have killed you. No. The other way around. Because all you have to do on Swain as soon as you get the snare is throw an EQ. That amplifies your Q, and since he maxes Q, he does a shit ton of damage. And then he just walks up and ults, and, like, you die. And then on top of that, with him running Deathfire Touch, you take an extra amount of damage, too. So it's, like, too much.
Yeah.
Okay, what I was gonna say was keep pushing until you see something. Right there, I was so tempted to jump, but then as soon as you saw the Malzahar, you back. Hell no. Not about that life. Not yet. Good job. You're dead. Never mind. Good flash. Bard? Yes? On the Yi? Okay. Hold on. I need to see this fight. Oh my god, see this? See this? He's at full HP. But that's not what I want to do to see. Okay. So, here, it's down. But, this, right here, wins them the fight. And I'll show you why. So first, you go back to try to get an auto off, but you can't. Right? Because it disappeared from vision. Remember when you were up here 1v1ing the Yi, and I told you to flash in here because it denies a vision? That kind of shit just happened. Like, you walked up and you stopped because you lost vision.
Yeah.
Right there. In doing so, he punishes you. Because that's what Swain is. Why he's one of my favorite low elo champions. Because he punishes you for mistakes like this. And because you stepped out of bounds, he's able to do this. Because, you know, you walk back and then walk forward instead of walking just forward, which would have allowed you to get out sooner. That little particle got you. Like, just a little bit more. And it got you. In doing so, he's able to get free damage off on you, forcing you to flash, getting a few autos off. Now, this is correct, killing the bard. However, you have to be able to react to the side, too. Like, what I mean is, on your game, I react to how my team is playing. Like, I'm tempted to jump here to kill the Yi, but I would also just sit here and just attack whoever, because Jinx just got a reset. So you can't afford to do that. And why would you ult Vlad? He sucks. So by killing the Jinx right there, like, you can reposition a little bit better. Like, the jump wasn't necessary is what I'm saying. You can't jump into a team of... You're not supposed to jump into Swain Mouse, because you have no magic resist to tank them. Now, while the jump is accurate, like, oh yeah, I would've jumped in because they're low, but, the thing is, like, you can't see them in that bush, so you're forced to jump into the bush, you know, and then you make your move, and then, in turn, you get fucked. So, at that time, I would not have jumped. And that's the only one time that I would say, don't jump there. Other than that, usually it's good to jump, or maybe if you kill one or two more. The jump is more of a good chasing tool during teamfights, too.
Yeah, okay.
Okay, don't buy, what's the name of the item? Energized dagger or something, right? It's like 750 gold, it builds out of a dagger and you upgrade it. Don't buy that unless you're really fucking desperate for gold. It's not efficient. It's like the stupidest item.
Yeah, I don't even know what
I'm doing. No, you're fine. Oh my god, no! Well, you're dead. What kind of a dodge was that? Oh my god! The fucking the Janna, like, dodged so badly. Alright. So right here? You did, well, this is okay, but right here, as soon as this went down, it's barring too big of a risk. Oh! Okay, that's probably why you couldn't react to it in time. It's no problem, it's fine, I guess. Actually, what would have been crazier is... You can use your heal to get out of the range by moving backwards. That is the only way you would have lived. That's bad.
Yeah.
Go Runan's Hurricane first, not the Shiv.
Okay.
Because when you get into team fights, you're able to hit more. Why would you stay there? Idiot, she's dead. Oh my god, she just... Oh my god. Oh my god. Oh my god. Oh my god! Why would you dive right here? Like, this isn't worth it. Like, unless you can kill him instantly with a lot of AP, no. He's also building death cap, so you know he's bad. This is free. Why would he do that? Oh, what's wrong with these guys?
I don't know.
Okay, that zap looked like it hurt. What the f- fuck's going on? Like, you're doing exactly what you need to do, clearing the wave. Oh my god, this is why it hurt. Oh my god, you see this? The fucking X of Doom.
I didn't even see it.
Oh my god. This is an easy fight. Hit the bard. Oh god! Careful on that, actually. Ah! Okay. Go, 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 go! Oh, okay, never mind. Okay. So your farsight trinket is up. Before you jump. Okay, so this is hard to see, but yes, this is good. Before you jump, warding here. That's all I have to ask for you to do. Because you don't lose. It's not like a warding trinket where you draw. Actually, all trinkets are the same now, because of the gin change. So what you want to do is you want to jump, and as you're jumping, you can drop a ward your trinket down, because it used to be where you all channels and recalls and stuff like that would be interrupted, but ever since Jin came into the fray, when he's channeling his ulti, some people like to use the blue trinket to get vision. So by getting vision while you're jumping in the air, you can, you know, make the move. Because right there, it's kind of the reason why I was saying no is because, like, there could be, like, it's the fog of war threat. Like, you don't have vision. Like, look at this entire dark area. Until you get a ward right here. Oh, there's only two of them. I'm jumping. You know, that kind of thing. Because, like, you don't know if Yi is gonna jump on the other side at all. Like, you don't know if Yi's just gonna cut you up as you jump in, and you have no way to jump out, and you can't really target him with his ulti, because, like, he's just gonna go, like, whoosh whoosh and, like, smack you with his alpha strike or something, you know? Like, you don't know that. So, just get vision on that. Before you jump, that's the only thing. Just, vision is just so important. Poop, pop, pop, pop. Alright, good job. See, now you deal damage.
Yeah.
But now you need to wait for more damage. That's where static or Runance Hurricane comes in. Okay, so right there. You got really low.
Yeah.
I'm thinking, mathematically, due to that, you can't do Baron. And you bar the risk of having them do Baron. The reason why? Okay, first of all, Kale used one heal. And it was on you. Not on Jax, not on Vladimir. Jax goes in. If he has more HP, he can do stuff. But he can't. Because he doesn't have enough magic resist to tank. In fact, he has, like, barely any at all. So, his heal is more efficient. Healing him is more efficient. Also, Janna didn't ulti, but that's irrelevant. That doesn't matter as much. Right here, look at their HP bars. They can do Baron.
Yeah.
Because with your HP bars, What are you gonna do? Baron is completely out of the question. You will all die if you guys do Baron. So, what are your options? Go back, because that's exactly what you're doing. All you guys have to recall, right? If they don't do Baron, they're idiots. Like, watch and watch. They're not gonna do fucking Baron. Like, Baron is absolutely free. Right now, for them. Baron is free, Jinx. And then, like, you have to know that they're doing it, because, like, health-wise, that is the only choice. Your trinket's up. You should use it on Baron. Don't drop it in the middle of Baron. Drop it right here in the corner. Because it's easier to see. Yep, there it is. Good. Wow, that was easy. So they're not doing it. Why? What the fuck? They actually could have finished it. With Jinx, Yi, Kale, Mouse Dot, Swain Dot, like, there's no way they could not finish that Baron right now. Like, what the fuck? Like, you guys sat here for, like, at least, like, 30 seconds, maybe. Something like that. I don't know. But, like, it was so free. Oh, my God. Why are they, like, oh, we're gonna bush cheese them. You know, 300 global gold for the entire team is actually a really good idea, but we're not gonna take it because, like, you know, silvers. It's so free. Look how free it is. You took a W to the face. You know, you could have dodged that, but you took a W. It's still free. In fact, they could just send Malzahar mid and still 4-man it. They could send Bard mid to wave clear, which is the stupidest thing to do, and they could still take it. I don't understand. This is the freest shit. Oh my god. And then Sway goes bottom. Oh my god. I have cancer. Oh my god. God. Free Baron. They you know what they could do with that, right? Like this Swain TP, no, he walked. So if they had Baron, you notice how they're all, in all three lanes. Let's say they took Baron. If they have all three lanes, you would actually be on your maneuver. Basically, you're supposed to be answering to his top, answering to mid, and answering to bot. Your wave clear, your team doesn't have good wave clear. You have to get Vladimir in the center of the enemy creep wave in order to blast it. And if somebody's standing there like a Swain, he's gonna wreck the Vladimir as he's trying to wave clear. So you guys are gonna be under a triple threat siege. 1-3-1. Or 2-2-1, it doesn't matter. They can send any amount of people distributed evenly across the entire map with Baron buff, and there's no way you can respond. Because Malzahar just has to press E against your team comp, and you die. Or your creep wave dies, and then this happens. Like, this, the Baron is still free. You're forced to respond to bot because of Swain. Then Swain just uses, like, just walks up there, because that's what the Swain is good at doing. Oh my god, this game is more of me just telling them how terrible their macro play is. They could actually, in fact, they don't even have to do a 1-3-1 split push. They could just do a 1-3-1 to just get the lanes in a 50-50 state, which is like here, here, and here. And then they just brute force mid, and they can just single-handedly end the game with Baron. You cannot fight back with them on Baron with giant minion waves in the way. Like, look, they're taking you apart one by one, and they're not going to be able to end the game. They could still take Baron at any point in the game, and you guys can't contest because you guys aren't fast enough to clear Baron compared to them. They have one dragon, you have one. You have Mountain Drake, which is really good for you to have, by the way. And they have Cloud Drake, which is fucking garbage. But that doesn't matter. Actually, it does matter. They can rotate quicker. And then they're going to get Ocean Drake. If they had Mountain Drake, they can take the Baron even faster. It's a good thing that you have Mountain Drake, actually. But, oh my god. This dragon doesn't matter. Look how fast they cleared it. Like, you barely cleared, like, three creeps, and they already finished it. They can literally end the game with Swain being this fed, with Malzahar being this fed, with Yi being this fed. With Jinx sort of being that fed. Like, they just need a little bit of, like, forced pressure. Like, brute force can actually win them the game. I hate saying that, but, like, that's how they're gonna win the game. Because that's the champions that they have. Good flash. They can act, like, if this was high elo and all this shit still happened, like, mechanically, which is kind of stupid, the game would be over already. Obviously, because it's, like, high elo, but, like, it would have been over already. Because the Baron call would have, like, ended the game. I don't know what Swain's, like, fucking fetishes at night, but like I don't know why he's always going bottom. Nice. Don't jump. Yeah. See, your trinket also plays a big part of fighting in there because like you can't see shit, and you might have killed two of them, and then one of them is bottom, but like you don't know where Malzahar is, like or if he has ult or not, because I didn't see him use it.
No.
On my screen, it also says he has ult, but like you know what I mean? Like you can't just jump in there without QSS.
No, it was the Malzahar I was thinking of when I was moving away.
Yeah. Like, the only wave clear you have aside from Vladimir is yourself. Like, and the thing is, you cannot wave clear without hitting it a shit ton. Until you get your Runance Hurricane, and until you get your Static Shiv up, you can't wave clear as fast as a Malzahar who presses E, and a Jinx who uses fucking Rockets autos.
Mm.
Okay. Baron is still free for them. Like, they don't need Swain to do it, like, to be honest. Like, I don't understand what their problem is with not doing Baron. Like, Baron can win them the game. You know, Baron actually also makes you win the game, too. If any of you guys decide to take Baron, like, right now, you guys can do it. Because their biggest AP threats are gone. Now it's just AD threats. All you have to do is zone them out with Vlad, or Kale, or both. You can't do jack shit. You should not do jack shit. But you zone them out. You do Baron. You take Baron. You guys can brute force mid. You are a siege. You're like the siege queen when it comes to blowing up towers because that's how you work, right? You're E. So in doing so, when Malzahar and Swain are dead, and you have Baron, who do you think is gonna wave clear? Like Jinx is gonna wave clear, but she can't kill the minions as fast. Only Malzahar can do it, and he won't clear it as fast. You know, like it's slow. But being slow, you come out on top. Oh, that's a kill. Nice. Jump on, hit the bard, just hit the bard. Or just push the minions. Finish pushing the minions. Okay, hit the Swain, just hit the Swain. New move. Okay, good. Hit the bard. Okay, yeah, that fucking, oh my god. They're Yi through right there. This is a waste of your time. If you get this tower, that's good. E the tower, yes. 1, 2, 3, 4, boom, 2, 3, 4, 5, Hit the minion to get lifesteal. Okay, well, that's good too. Kill this inhib, get the Baron. Ping Baron. I better be seeing some pings on Baron right now. You guys can't end the game.
No.
I don't see where are my pings? I mean, if you guys get one Nexus turret, it's fine. But this is the greatest risk of all. I take things that are free, like I said. Oh my god. Why didn't he ult? Oh, he doesn't have ult. This is such a big risk. You guys aren't healthy enough for this. I mean, you are, but like that doesn't mean you can do it. No!
Yeah.
Why? Swain, you suck! Well, Maria, it was nice knowing you.
Yeah.
Oh my god. Okay, so yes, you actually could have done a little bit more. Okay, so here's another thing. I'm gonna backspace it up. Okay. I'm gonna watch you as you take this inhibitor, okay? So here's what you can do. Mathematically, they are gonna respawn. Like, that's the word. Mathematically, they're gonna respawn and they're gonna have numbers advantage over you. Like, because of their health and the way your mana is positioned, like looking at your Kayle, she's running out of mana, you have blue buff because Kayle doesn't have it, Jax doesn't have it, Jax is not healing as fast as he needs to. So, you guys aren't gonna come out on top of this, without losing some members on your team. So, after taking the inhib, what you can do is you can clear some of the creeps. Some, not all. Kill these creeps. Boom, bang, bomb, bomb, boom. Okay, stop right there. Before you do anything else, look at the map. This is free too. So take this,
yeah.
And then you regroup around here. Some players will choose the back, but this is absolutely free. And the reason why it's free is because look at the minion wave you built here. They have to answer to this. Otherwise, you know, they're going to take a little bit more damage on their Nexus turret. So this is free. You can take it. What you have is you have jump. Walk here, jump here. Walk this way into the danger zone, and then just kill it. And then leave. That's free. You take a tower, an inhib, and an extra tower for free. But also, you cannot forget how impeccable this tower is, and the reason why is because by taking this tower, you're forcing this big creep wave so someone else has to respond to this. By backing afterwards, you guys can do Baron. And remember the importance of me stressing out Baron so many fucking times. Lol, good flash. You know, like the Baron call, like...
Yeah.
Because now they don't have to answer to one late wave of pressure, the mid. They also have to answer to this big-ass fat wave of pressure. If you took that tower, it would be around here by now, like here. And then they have to answer to it. Now, because we didn't rotate, they can do this. And yeah. I don't know what their obsession is with trying to kill y'all, but this is a free Baron. Take the goddamn Baron. Oh my god. You're killing me. This could have been... Yeah, thank you. See, look at that. Jinx and Malz and Bard didn't have to be there. You see how fast that thing went down? Like... You see, like, if they, I don't know if their brains, like, figured this out, like, moments later, but, oh, look how fast we took Baron. You know, we could have done that 5, 6, 7 minutes ago. But they didn't. God! And the only reason it's, like, say it was Lee Sin. Lee Sin would be struggling. Nidalee would be struggling. Master Yi, he just has to right-click it, because he's so fast, he shreds it down so quickly. That's why I'm stressing him. Because he's basically an AD carry. So having 2 AD carries on it, with a shit ton of attack speed and crit, is gonna guarantee that it dies in like that. And it did die like that!
Yeah.
God forbid me. Oh my god. Holy. For the love of all that is fucking sweet and holy. Candyland. Like, god damn it. Alright, so the Bloodthirster buy is actually not optimal here. I was wrong. And the reason why is because you don't have Mercurial Scimitar. I would prefer... You pick either Mercurial or Bloodthirster. If you feel like they can't break you with a CC ability, just get Mercurial, honestly. I mean, get Bloodthirster, but... While you're damaging... Jump! Jump! Pause. Fog of War. If you jumped on her, he's out of position. He can't get to her in time. I know that. And the reason why I know that is because... Think about it like this. No... Bard is down there, so he can't save her. Where is Master Yi? He had to back, and the reason why he has to back is because he's the one who killed Baron, so he's probably going around, like, buying items or something right now. But there is no way he's actually smart enough to listen to his team and go bottom and group, because that's not how a Master Yi plays. I don't know why, but, like, I just had the urge that Master Yi wasn't going to group with the Jinx. Like, it just didn't feel right for me. Like, it's probably just intuition. It sounds crazy, but Master Yi didn't group, and look, he's at base. I don't know why. I just knew, like, he's not gonna group with you guys. He could kill this Jinx right now. So right there, I would've jumped. I would've slaughtered this. You guys, you could kill the Jinx. Look at her items. She has no speed. You win. Like, there is no way you lose. You have the exact same items as her, and this boot, but you have these two. You win. 100%. You win. You cannot lose. And don't do it now, Jesus Christ. Okay, good. Yes, good ward, good ward. But yeah, you won that. If you jumped on her right then and there, you won. Like, right, straight up, 100%. Then you jump again into whatever. You could jump into the Netherlands if you felt like it afterwards, but like, yeah. How'd you get stunned? Oh, the call died. Hello?
Hi.
Okay. Okay, we can see?
Yeah.
Okay, so the benefit of QSS right there is as soon as you get stunned, you could have broken it.
Yeah.
Now, QSS is very skill-based because, like, split timing of it can win you a fight. So, the only time you take it is because this is a Malzahar, you have to take it. Wow, you fucking suck, Jax.
I think I realized it the next time I die by his ultimate.
Wait, are you building GA?
Yeah.
I still stand by the executioner's calling. And the reason why is because if you look at Jinx, as stupid as it is, she's getting a GA, but that means she has armor. Master Yi has Dead Man's Plate, means he has armor. Your damage is great, but you need that extra push. Plus, don't forget that Executioner's Calling does shit. Jump, 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 jump. Oh! You have flash? Okay, well. Alright, so your jumps are fine, but they're just late. Like, you're jumping, yes, but they're late. Right there, you would have to jump sooner because then Bard would have to ult a little bit differently. Wait, you don't end it here? How?
No.
Oh, they have Baron, that's right. So now you just have the threat of Yi. Lifesteal off the minions. Constantly lifesteal off the minions. Hit the Yi. Don't get into tower range. This is basically about micro. When I say hit the minions, I mean your goal is to clear them out. Oh god. Oh my god. Oh god. Alright. Move in between your autos and move down constantly. Oh god. Like your pathing should be like instead of standing here and shooting it and moving down slowly, you should be like every auto, if you have your Q up, you should be moving like this, like click, 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 click. You should be like doing like a fucking arc, like a little like a curve this way, so that you don't get hit by skill shots and stuff like that. Cause like the way you were standing was like really straight, which allowed him to like just get like, huh, she's not moving diagonally. I'm just gonna throw a Q here and see if it lands, and it landed, and I was like, okay. I would recommend not going a defensive item, because that's not how you carry games. Does a defensive item give you damage? No, so like, that's my reasoning behind it. Like, the only time I go defensive is on supports, because in Challenger games, Snowball, or it's Challenger Master Diamond games, it's all snowball-y. So like, yeah. Yeah, I would do that too. It's called the nope. Wait, kill him! Flash, ye. Whoa! Careful for that. Remember that your QSS can also break snares, so this is, if you had a QSS here, it would be really good.
Yeah.
But honestly, your damage means nothing without Last Whisper. Like, this Swain is so bent up on building so much damage to try to snowball. And it's not wrong, but like, what actually, it is wrong. When you're winning, you should build defensive items only because it makes it harder for you to die. Right here, you build offensive items because it was harder for you to kill. It's hard for you to win without them. Plus your AD carry, you only build offense. Jinx delayed her fucking power spike by building defense, which is the stupidest thing I've ever seen. And remember that when you get Executioner's Calling, you don't just cut Swain's healing in half, you also cut Yi's healing in half, and he gets a lot of lifesteal because he attacks really fast, and he also has Meditate, so denying his Meditate is really good. Bard also heals people, Jinx has her own heal plus lifesteal, so you can't just drop and ignore the fact that they have a lot of healing on their team, which you are able to cut in half. Now, the other option is Lord Dominic's Regards, but I'm against that in this game only because there isn't really a big tank on their team that has enough HP that is truly that truly makes the item effective. Okay? Just hit whoever. That's fine. Jump over the wall, if anything. That's fine. Oh, you win this. Oh my god, QSS would be so hot right here. You would have gotten a quad.
Yeah.
Kill somebody. Hit. Oh my god. They all should have died to you right there, to be honest. I would have killed them all. Fuck. If I had QSS, though. Like mainly because, like, that standstill there, like, wrecked you. Like, you kind of just had to, like.
Yeah.
Well, I want to... Like, you had the urge to kill them all. I can feel it. But, like, you can't. Because you can't move. Okay. Yeah, if you had the ability to move right there after QSS, also she can't McKayle's your don't forget she cannot McKayle's your suppression from Mal's. So even if she had McKayle's, she would not have done anything to help you out. Really? Wow. So you're telling me this Vladimir also does- What's with people not building Zhonya's?
I don't know, maybe they don't know how to
Swain,
use it.
Swain was supposed to build Zhonya's. Like, if Swain built Zhonya's, I would still take Executioner's Calling. Now, if you don't know this, Zhonya's on Swain still allows Swain to get healing. Like, while he's in the bird form and he's in his crow form, he still gets healing. With that being the case, if he's Zhonya's when he's really low HP, and you have Executioner's Calling on him, you will cut his healing in half, which is good, because then when he comes out, you can just kill him.
Okay.
Good dodge. Do the Baron. The damage dealers that matter the most on their team are down. Do not E the Baron. E it when it's at 2,000 or 3,000 HP. Like, I'm serious. Like, right about now, you should really E it. I knew it!
Yeah.
I fucking knew it! Like, I don't know if you can understand the reason why I'm telling you to E it, because, like, I know that, like, you're probably gonna lose Smite out. Like, I don't know why. What is this? Like, am I a prophet or something? Fuck my life. Oh my god, I knew it.
After. That I should have done it because I already knew that Jax wasn't that good, so...
He's the jungler, right? What a joke. What did you fucking smite? I'm gonna watch him. I'm gonna see exactly what he did, what he smited. I'm gonna go back like 30 seconds. If I fucking see a smite... Like, why can't I see a smite? Like, if this is bothering me, it's not like the cooldown is like off. He has red smite too. It's even worse. Like red smite on Jax is actually fine. It's just that like he's not hitting people. He had to hit people in order to make it work. I fucking knew it. Holy shit! I knew it. Like you have to drop the E on it because then like the explosive damage like will burst it. The other thing you could do is you could just stop hitting the Baron and just start hitting them. That could work too.
Yeah.
But you don't have to. You it's more important that you get the Baron. It's atrocious as shit. Whatever. Game's fucking over. Oh my god. God, that has got to be the stupidest thing I've ever seen. Like, fuck. The Baron call is correct. Just like our play. And the inhibitor respawns. Huh.
Yeah.
Swain actually does a lot more damage than that I usually have him for, but like, what the fuck? Like, there's no way they can still win this game. Look at the bot lane wave. Like, fuck top. Who cares? Look at the bot lane wave. In fact, they could just go for Force Elder. Why is top tower a priority when Elder Dragon is up? They have three dragons. Why is top tower a priority when Elder Dragon is up? What the fuck?
I don't think anyone in silver considers Elder Dragon a thing. So...
what happens when you don't have Zhonya's? Like, what the fuck? Also, don't forget that Elder Dragon also gives 250 global gold, which is basically the same amount as Baron, but just like 50 gold short. Like, what the fuck? You guys can do it. In fact, if you're crazy, you can solo. Oh, you don't have armor pen, right? You can solo it. Like, their team composition was supposed to be, like, amazing. They could have won so much more efficiently. You guys can kill easily now. Oh, that was a good stunt. Jump. Just keep jumping around. Kill that Jinx. He's over the wall. Just go. Oh my god, lol. She has GA. Doesn't matter. Jump over the wall, killer. You have burn damage. I would jump over the wall. I would jump over the wall. I would jump over the wall. Please jump over the wall. Yeah! That's what I'm talking about. Like, it took you a long time. Come on. Like, god. Doesn't matter if she stands up and continues the fight. You're fucking Trist. Boom. Okay, well, there's a little... No, stop hitting the tower. There's an open nexus! Holy... Stop! Just get the fucking... Just kill me now, fuck. Jesus Christ, it's over. Never have to deal with this shit again. Like, it's just... There were 94 kills spread across this game. 94 kills spread across the whole fucking game. I just cannot, like, contemplate this, like, atrocity. Oh my god, that was a journey. That's all I have to say is that was a fucking journey. Like...
Oh, this happens a lot, and that's really what I have the most problem with.
A lot of the times, it's your decision making to jump. And that's what makes you that's what's going to, at least, make you a better player. Your decision making. So, knowing, oh, I should jump here. Isn't safe for me to jump. You can't just assume, like, you can't just assume it's always good to jump. Like, yes, it's great to jump, but, like, you can't just do it, like, willy-nilly. Like, you know how I'm telling you, it's like, oh, yeah. You gotta jump calculatively. You know, like, most of the time, the jumps that I'm telling you to jump on are good, and it's like, what the fuck, wait, what the fuck, is this, is that actually happening? Most of the jumps I'm telling you to jump on are correct, but the times I'm telling you not to jump is because you don't have vision. That's the only threat. Like, oh, I know where everyone is, I think it's safe to jump. I don't know where anyone is, I probably shouldn't jump, that kind of thing. You know what I mean? Like,
yeah.
That's the best way to, that's the best way to approach it. Just knowing exactly when to jump and knowing exactly when not to jump. Oh, it was a glitch. Jesus Christ. I saw a 136-minute game and I was like, what the fuck? And then on top of that, we also got, let's see. Your rune page is fine. Your other thing was fine. I am trying to figure out, your laning phase was more of, like, the same thing. It's probably just a habit now, but, like, a lot of the times when they walk up, there's a difference between walking up and, like harassing, and then walking up and taking, like, just out of position. Like, sometimes they can walk up, and they're still within the range of their AD carry. So if you try trading with it, what happens is, if they're standing next to each other, you don't want to trade with them. So let me draw a picture example for you to make it a lot, to visualize it a lot easier. So, alright, here we go. Pablo Picasso. Let's fucking go. Show me my mechanics of drawing. So, your blue side. Let's do green. This is the lane. This is the. It's not the lane. This is the fucking. This is the lane. Alright, and then these are the bushes. Fantastic fucking art right here. Alright, and now this is blue side. So, this is you. And this is the support. And this is the enemy team, and this is their support. Now, every champion has like their own this what we call an attack radius or their diameter, right? And your goal is to always stand in a Venn diagram position. As long as they're always overlapping each other, you're basically in a safe zone. It's the same thing for the opponents. If you guys cross each other's zones, you guys can start fighting and hitting each other and stuff like that. However, the bard was constantly stepping out of position. So like when he was stepping out of position, and he's right here, so this is his circle, this is your circle, and this is your support circle, and this is his circle. And every moment, every instant he stepped out of position, like this big gap right here, you can punish him because he has to, he has to get back into position. They call it parallel movement for supports and AD carries. So by him stepping out of position, and you can just constantly punish that. It's most prevalent when they stand in the bush and your AD and the AD carry is like in the middle of the lane trying to CS. Instead of the AD carry being like right here and here, instead the AD carry is over here and here, you just collapse on him in the bush. Like that's pretty much all you have to do. But also you can't do that on your own. Like you can't just stand like when you were here and he was like up here, but the AD carry was here. You just go on him because then she has to go down to get to you, and then you by the time you get one auto off, you just. You go here, and then you juke back, and then you go forward, and then you juke back. And then, when it came to the inhibitor, that's one thing. That's just parallel movement. You'll kind of feel it. Like, it's just like, oh, this support is short range. This support is melee. It's like, oh, I just have to stand, like, really close to them. Just don't stand near walls, because that's how Bard works. And then, the inhibitor was like, I'll just do this, because that's the inhibitor. Oh, no, I said blue. Let's just keep it at blue. The inhibitor, when you hit it, like, earlier, you gotta... When Malzahar does his thing, it was like this. So instead, I would just like move forward, move down, move down, and move down. Every one of these movements, like you stop here, you stop here, you stop here. That's an auto in between. So you're constantly moving in between your autos. You gotta move in between your autos in order to generate attack move, so that you can reposition constantly. And you also can't just like do it in a one straight linear motion either, because let's say your target's here and your attack moving like trying to kite. You don't just attack move. Like this way all the time. You go like this, 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 this. And then let me think. Baron calls. This game was so easy with the Baron calls. I told you I would explain it in this game. They could have taken it like at any time. They just chose not to. And that really frustrates me because like, and maybe they don't understand the benefit that Baron can actually win them the game right there. They have the ability to not for the next 3.5 minutes they could have ended the game. Like they or not ended the game, but like take so many objectives and establish a gold dominance over you guys, forcing you guys to play from behind for a set period of time. And then they just rinse and repeat because all they have to do is pick you off for being reckless and you die. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Yeah. So that's pretty much that. And your Baron calls are pretty easy, except for the time. God fucking damn it! I don't know how. I just can't fucking believe it. Executioner's calling. Itemization wise, it was actually optimal for you to build that item at that exact time. And the reason why was because it's just too good of an item. For the benefits that you get over the negatives, you would receive a lot of healing reduction. You would receive a lot of armor pen. They did have armor on their team. Take that into consideration. Always consider building Last Whisper and Executioner's Calling under the circumstance that they have at least two people with armor on their teams, whether or not they're tanks. But the sooner you kill, I would consider Mortal Reminder here only because they have a bunch of healers. Let's say they don't have healers and they don't have tanks. Well, then that means like your BT option was fine, but you can take it a step further, and you can go something else. Blade of the Ruined King. That's also fine.
Okay.
Just weigh your options for that. And if you want to go a defensive item, that's even crazier. Maw Mamordius is even better, but like it's really rare that people will ever get that item as a Tristana because like you're basically dead anyway. Like, if it triggers, you're fucking dead anyway. That's pretty much it. I'm trying to think if there's any anything else. Jumping in and out, jumping with vision, going back into your team. For dodging skill shots, it's pretty simple. You see it based on the way they move. Like, if they stop moving, probably means that they're casting a skill shot. So just move backwards. You gotta respond accordingly. You can't do it reactively. Like, it wasn't wrong of you to like when the bard thing killed you. First of all, it's bullshit that, like, even though you flew across the map or something, it'll still hit you. It's so awkward. But
Yeah.
what you would do is you would as soon as he stops moving, you jump, or you just jump really soon. It's because if he's good, he would have shot it in the air and landed it like halfway, which interrupts your jump 100%. So that's a problem. And I don't think I have anything else. I can't think of anything else off the top of my head. Your runes and masteries, everything was fine. Just don't take the gold mastery. Oh yeah, don't force chuck a potion early, because like it's not like if you want to trade, you want to force their support to burn potions. But supports can afford to burn potions because that's how they work.
Yeah.
So instead, just try to force their potions to be burnt, because every potion you burned is 50 gold. And you can't forget that.
Okay.
Ah, Jesus Christ, that clown fiesta is like, I'm at shock that like they just didn't do Baron. Like, oh my God, Baron is so free. Like,
Yeah,
they could have
that's
taken like
like.
four towers in every single lane plus one extra bread boot force. Like, mathematically, that would bring you, let's see, that's 100, at least 100 gold each, so that's 500 each. So they get 2k gold on top of Baron, which is 1.5k gold. So they get at least 3k gold if done correctly. And guess what? They didn't do it. Unbelievable.
But I feel like both teams just kept throwing a
Oh yeah,
lot.
you guys killed yourselves like 50 times. God, and that was fucking great. Jesus Lord. Oh my God, I'm so it's like pretty tilting that shit, but it's okay.
Was so scared that we would throw too much and then lose, 'cause, yeah.
Master Yi is good enough to hyper carry that game, to be honest.
Yeah.
But you have damage too, so it's fine. Okay. Well, let me know if you're gonna, like, cause like you play a lot more like after these sessions to know about what to do. A lot of it just comes down to a lot of punishment. That's what, like, the champions that punish like Swain and Tristana for support. It's like Leona, like those kind of champions are easy to climb with because like they just like, oh, here's a mistake, I'm punishing it. Oh, here's a mistake, I'm punishing it.
Yeah.
Yeah, so it's pretty easy. The only difference is decision making when it comes to Tristana's jumps. If you make a good call, it's fine if you're like not mechanically gifted on the champion. Just your decision making is what matters most. So if you guys Baron correctly, if you guys take objectives correctly, if you siege a tower properly, all that coming into play will grab you a higher elo. Because like, oh, I took Baron because I felt it was right as a call. And if you win the game off of that call, well, what happened to your decision making? Did it improve? Hell yeah. You know what I mean? Like, the thing is,
Yeah.
if you call Baron and it is the correct call, but it is the wrong circumstances, then obviously you're gonna throw, you know? Like, every time I told them to do Baron, it was absolutely correct. You guys had like you had no damage to stop them. You had your health bars were too low. Like, you can analyze the situation like, hey, that's a correct situation for Baron. And instead of doing Baron, they do bush cheese. Like,
Yeah.
bush cheese. Bush cheese above all things. Above a chance, not even a chance, a swing from, like, the games are always 50-50, right? It goes from
Yeah.
50 to 50 to 55, to maybe 60-40 in their favor to win the game. And they choose bush cheese. Like, fuck. Like, holy crap. I mean, they do the Baron later, and I even told you, like, how easy it was for them to do Baron, as a demonstration of how easy it was for them to do Baron. And
Yeah.
it's just so sad that they couldn't do it. And it's not that they can't either, like, oh, we totally can't. They were all full health. It's just like the situation was perfect. So if you consider your team's Baron calls like that too, like, here's the simplest way: two people are dead and a wave is shoving. It's easy, but it can't just be any two people. It has to be the jungler, and maybe one of the laners, excluding the support. Just if the support's dead, don't do Baron. But if the jungler's dead and, like, let's say the mid laner's dead, do Baron. If the jungler's dead and the top laner's dead, do Baron. If the jungler's dead and the AD carry is dead, best option, do Baron. If three of them are dead, do Baron. If you have the health bars and two of them are dead and one of your top lanes or bot lanes are shoving, so that forces them to lose a man up there to send it to respond, do Baron. Those are just basic ways to approach doing Baron. But after doing Baron, don't fight back, because you need it. You need to back, because sometimes Barons are really risky. And yes, you can even do Baron at 20 minutes. So you can win games at 20 minutes. They could have done a lot more at 20 minutes if they did it right. But no, push cheese. Fuck my life. Alright. That's enough of me ranting about the cheesing in the bush. Are there any further questions you have?
Like, I don't know what really could have changed it for my team. Like, both teams just kept farming, so...
If you guys bombed the Baron and took the Baron...
Yeah, okay.
That's pretty much the only thing.
Another thing I normally see with these kinds of games, because they happen a lot, is that people don't understand who to protect and who to focus.
Yeah.
And, like, if somebody gets caught out, how do you play around that if they just run in and die?
Don't flame, but
no, I don't.
Yeah, that's one thing you shouldn't do. Remember that it's all up to you to carry. So like, if they get caught out, but if you're all inning them, you don't have to rely on the support. Just think of it like you will do this. You will 1v9 basically. That's how solo queue works.
Okay.
All right, my computer's frozen for a little bit. Jesus. Where's my OBS? Okay. I hope it doesn't crash. Okay. It's still good. Alright. Let me know, okay, like, how you do by the end of the season.
I will.
Yeah.
Okay.
Alright, and I'll catch you later. This episode will be up, like, tomorrow or something.
Okay.
Alright. Have a good one.
You too.
Alright guys, thanks for watching. This has been LOL Veggie. You can find me on Twitter, well, at LOL Veggie, and follow me on Skype and for more coaching inquiries. And that's pretty much it. I'll see you guys later.